Hello, Jeff Green here, and I just want to take a few minutes and go through a couple of slides and hopefully answer some questions that people are asking me sort of on a regular basis nowadays, given the different market that we're in as compared to the beginning of the year. So people ask me about home price predictions. They ask me, is it better to buy a home in 2022 or 2023? Or should I wait until 2024 to buy a house? So these are questions that are upmost on many people's minds. So I'm going to go through a couple of charts that will explain these, and then we'll go through some what I think are some key takeaways. So here are the five major sort of price analysts and price forecasters for real estate across the United States. We've got Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, MBA, HBS, National Association of Realtors, and this Zelman organization run by Ivy Zelman that's pretty prominent in real estate price projections. So you'll see there's five sort of major projections here. Zelman is the only one that's indicating a 4% decrease for 2023. The other four vary from 4.4% to 1.2% increase. So if you average these six numbers together, you come to an average of about 1.8% increase for home prices in 2023. So I think that's not unreasonable given what's going on in the market. I don't think interest rates are going to go to the moon, but you never know. So this is a fairly sort of thumbnail number you can depend on, maybe 1.8% for 2023. Okay, so what happens after 2023? Everybody wants to know. So you take those same sort of organizations and you come up with a 2024, 2025, 2026 projection, and I take with a grain of salt anything that goes out more than 3 or 4, maybe 5 or 6 months. But nevertheless, 86% of those analysts polled think that prices are going to go up in 2024. These small sliver and this sliver is no change and maybe depreciation. So there's no numbers on there, but 86% think prices are going up. Even more think prices will go up in 2025, and even more think that prices will go up in 2026. I think between here and 2026, I think it's a pretty good bet that prices will go up. We're still short of houses in this country, and demand is increasing. So that's what is projected to happen for the next, 3, 4 years. So what are my key takeaways on these estimates? So the majority of experts expect home prices to increase over time. I think that's supported by the charts. I don't think I would disagree with that. Almost no one in the industry is currently expecting a major crash like 2008, right around that time frame. The economics in the real estate market just doesn't point to a crash like 2008. We had people buying houses who couldn't afford the payments at all, and they were dumped on the market. And we don't have that now. We have tightened loan standards. Most everybody has some equity going in and has built a substantial amount of equity in the price increases over the last 2 or 3 years. So most people are not moving. Interest rates are certainly higher. They're almost reaching the long-term average of between 6 and 7%. They've shot up over the last couple of weeks, but they're very volatile. There are ways to get those prices down. But the strategy is date the rate and marry the lower price, right? You can always refinance at a lower rate when rates do come down, which will lower your price, will lower your payment, but your price will be locked in. So that's sort of the strategy there. Forget that you're paying a little bit higher rate than you were. Get into a house that you want, and fix the price. More inventory is on the market from which to select. If you were pushed out of the market earlier this year in the March-April timeframe just because there were just so many buyers, now is the time to buy. Now's the time to buy with seller concessions sort of increasing. You can use seller concessions to buy down the interest rate. You now get a chance to do an inspection. It was crazy. I mean, people were buying houses and they'd waive every inspection in the book. They'd get in the house, the garage door is falling off, the landscaping doesn't work, all sorts of things. And other buyer protections that you just couldn't get just even a few months ago. So you're much safer buying a house now. Sellers are a little bit more flexible on price, and you can buy down your interest rate. So if you're interested in pursuing some of that, don't hesitate to give me a shout. So here are some thoughts. If you tried to buy earlier this year in that buying frenzy, now is the time to start looking. One of these days, this interest rates are going to start coming down again, and this real estate market is going to accelerate in the opposite direction. You don't want to get left out the next time around. So now's the time to start getting qualified for loans and start finding out what's on the market and really what you'd like to live in. The second item, my thoughts, is if you need to move to sell your next home, if you need to sell to move your next home, that can be tough, but the market status is really not an issue. Now's the time to start looking, right? If you're selling a price that selling a house is high priced and buying a house that's high priced, it's kind of a wash. But I have strategies that help you buy your second house before you sell your original house, right? So you can buy, move in, and then sell. There's lots of loan strategies that I can help you with, so you don't have to go carry a mortgage and hope like heck that your current house sells. That can be a very worrisome thing to do. The third thought that strikes me is if you rent, remember that 100% of your rental payment is a total loss. You're throwing money into the trash. If you are paying $1,000 or even $2,000 in rent, let's say you're paying $2,000 a month in rent, you are throwing $24,000 a year into the garbage can. So think about that for a little bit. Start building equity now with payments that are usually lower than rent. I find that most renters that are paying the average rent of right around $2,500 can get into a house for less than $2,500. So those are my thoughts. If you'd like more information or talk to me about any of these issues, give me a shout, 602-790-2927. Or you can email me directly at jeff@jeffgreenrealtor.com. Or you can just get more info at jeffgreenrealtor.com. There's a wealth of information at that link. So I hope this is helpful. Don't hesitate to give me a shout. I hope you have a wonderful day. Thank you.